Hello, I'm Francesco and I work in the biophysical imaging group, and today I want to show you an example of how we can do a tracking experiment with the Minflux microscopy. The sample that I will show you today is just a simple supported lipid bilayer, which is a model membrane that we will now prepare by spin coating and we will mount on the microscope to demonstrate the lipid tracking capabilities of Minflux. So I have my prepared glass substrate here. In this sample, we have two fluorescent species, a green fluorescent species that we will use for locating the sample in our focus, and a red fluorescent species that we are interested in tracking. And now we can do some imaging. I'm now mounting the sample that we made upstairs. Of course, this is a model sample. We can also use cellular samples and viral samples. This is safe. It's got wide field fluorescence as well. The diffusion of lipids, proteins, and other molecules on the cellular membrane is particularly interesting because the membrane is the gateway to the cell, and a lot of phenomena which are related to the communication of the cell with the external environment are localized and take place on the cellular membranes. For this reason, the diffusion of molecules on the cellular membrane is of particular interest, and it's always a complex motion which involves freely diffusing areas, but also confinement areas in which particles localize for longer times. We believe that these localization areas, that these confinement areas, hold particular interest in the economy of the cell interacting with the environment and in processes such as cellular signaling or the immune response, for example. The Minflux technique and the Minflux microscope excel in high resolution, but also in high frame rate tracking in our experience. So on the one side, the Minflux is able to get images with the resolution in the nanometer level, which is already an improvement to existing super resolution techniques. But also, it is able of tracking particles at frame rates close to 10 kilohertz. So 0.1 milliseconds per localization. So when the Minflux finds a particle, it locks onto it and tracks it until the fluorescence disappears due to phenomena like quenching of fluorescence or bleaching of fluorescence. We find it easy to track particles we use in the Minflux microscope. And these particles in our projects are mainly lipids diffusing on membranes, such as model membranes or also cellular membranes, and also, in perspective, proteins diffusing on other particles, like virus-like particles. Thanks to its tracking capabilities, the Minflux is able to give us detailed information on the mobility of particles constituting the cellular membranes, model membranes, or also viral membranes in a very specific way. And we are able to gain more insights on the phenomena that take place on these surfaces. We are able to gain insights in the diffusion and the mobility of particles constituting the cellular membrane, viral membranes, or model membranes, thanks to the Minflux advanced tracking capabilities. When the Minflux is faced with a diffusing sample, we can use it in tracking mode. In this modality, we can search for particles in the region of interest, and then the Minflux will lock onto a specific particle and follow it until the fluorescence from the signal is not detected anymore. And then we switch to another particle. The Minflux also excels at high resolution imaging, with the resolution in the range of nanometer, which is already an improvement from existing super resolution techniques.